Alright YouTube, in today's school tutorial we're gonna be doing a very interesting high-end commercial look, relatively simple with an easy few steps. Before we start, I want to say special thank you to Rawfilm for providing this clip for you guys. Be sure to check them out, links in the description below. Okay, so here we have our clip from Rawfilm. To be fair, it's not raw file I'm working on right now. I specifically downloaded 1080p version, so technically I don't even know what configuration of this log right now I'm looking. If we're gonna go here, we can see that there's no information. It's been shot on red camera, but as of right now it's a ProRes file, so we kind of basically starting the blind game. I know a lot of you guys been saying that I always color grade raw files, so to be fair, now we're working with a ProRes. That way you can see the concept is the same. Anyways, so I'm gonna do a new node, okay, just like this. And for this one, I'm gonna call this one exposure slash contrast, okay? And it's very simple. All I have to do right now is to play with the contrast, because I really wanted to give a nice high-end commercial kind of look, so we give it a nice punch. Okay, so I think like that looks great. Let's check it out before and after really quick. Okay, I think like that looks pretty cool. Now, pay attention also, I'm not dropping down my blacks all the way down, because we have to kind of make a common sense out of it. And if you look at the picture, we can see that there is nothing really technically 100% black, so there's no reason for us to drop this kind of thing. I know a lot of people make a mistake, they always drop this thing down, but don't be one of those people. Do not drop exposure always down, okay? It's not the right thing to do. So another new note. And now we're gonna start introducing a little bit of look. Now, of course, depending on how things shot and the location and all that, order of operation is completely different. So in this case, I'm gonna start working on the water. Because it's kind of overcast, and relatively the water is clean, and this is a really cool thing about shooting like that, we actually have a little bit of color in the water. And this is fantastic, because now we can actually do whatever we want. So if I'm gonna go on a qualifier over here and I'm gonna turn on the highlight, I'm gonna click on the water, and I can just drag it up a little bit. We basically selected all the water. So I'm gonna go down a little bit, because I don't wanna introduce that selection to a little beanie and the glasses. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna do clean black a little bit and clean white. Okay, something like this. And I'm going to start introducing blur radius, because the action happens so quickly. At this point, even if there's a little bit of noise, because it's a water and splashes and whatnot, we actually can completely get away with it. So we still have a little bit of beanie. Let's do more black, just like that. Okay, and now we have a very nice clean selection. So I'm going to get out of there. And I'm gonna start introducing saturation. Okay, so we have a very nice saturated water. And now what I'm gonna do, just with a hue, I can completely change how it looks. So I kinda wanna do a little bit sort of teal. Let's check it out before and after. Before we had a little bit green, now it's a little bit teal. I think it looks a little bit more pleasant to our eyes like that. However, it's absolutely your decision. You can make it blue, you can make it green. It's completely up to you. There, in this case, green and blue working very well together. So there is no right or wrong in this case. Okay. So here we have it. What happens now? I'm going to do another node. And now, just to save my time on selecting things, I'm going to connect this little blue to arrow. And if we're going to go back, we have exactly the same selection. So what we can do now is to go in the key and we can reverse it. Okay. So it's a very cool trick that you can do. That way you can save a little bit of time. That way you don't have to pick things again and, you know, whatever the client sitting in the back, whatnot. So it's a really cool technique to use. Anyways, so now we're basically working on the skin. Okay. So with the skin, what am I going to do? Well, the first thing I want to do, I want to give it a little bit of pop. So I'm going to do a little bit of contrast. Okay. And with the pivot, I'm going to go a little bit down because I don't want to go too much. I don't want it to look too crazy. Okay. So just like that is okay. And what we can do now, if we want, we can introduce a little bit more contrast, or we can actually minimize the contrast. So let me do a point here. And by the way, there's multiple ways of doing this. And I'm going to do a point here. And basically by dragging this down, we can control how much contrast we want. If we want to introduce, we'll go up. If we want to minimize, we'll go down. So let's see, I kind of want to do a little bit, something like this. I think looks cool. Let's check it out before and after. So now we start getting a very overall nice image. Look at that. It looks like a high-end commercial now. Let's go again, before and after. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Another thing what we can do, and it's relatively very simple trick, but in the shots like that, it works very, very well. So let's go into window and select a little circular little window over here like this. Okay, let's inverse this and introduce a little bit of vignetting. That way our eyes naturally kind of go to a swimmer. Now I wanted to do a little bit aggressive in this case, so something like that, and nice vignette, that way nobody can tell. So let's see really quick before and after, and as we can see, we start getting that very high-end looking commercial. It's very simple relatively. I mean, we're only doing like very basic steps. So what I'm gonna do now is we're gonna do a very interesting technique. We're gonna call this one bleach bypass. Okay, and with this one, I'm going to go over here into RGB mixer. I'm going to select monochrome. And in monochrome, I'm going to adjust my settings. That way, primarily, his skin looks nice. Okay, it's very simple. I'm not going to go in this tutorial about the science behind RGB channels. I've covered that in my previous videos, but I'm just going to dial it by the eye. Now, when you work on RGB, it's very important. Let me zoom in over here. It's very important that you don't do too much because you're going to start getting a lot of artifacts if you're going to crank one of the parameters too much. So it's going to be unusable. So when you do, make sure that your skin still looks relatively good. Or not just skin in general, your image. Because you don't want to introduce this kind of a blotchy artifact on anything. Okay, so really quick, before and after. So it looks really cool to my eyes. What I'm going to do now, Alt-L, we're going to convert it to a layer mixer. We're going to go over here and we're going to select soft light. So now it kind of looks like Saving Private Ryan, which I don't want to do because I still want to kind of keep that fresh commercial look. So I'm going to select all this, right click, create compound node. Okay, just like that. And again, we're going to go into key window. And with the gain, I'm going to be able to control how much I want to introduce that look. Okay, so depending on the commercial or the feel that you want to introduce, basically you dial in to your flavor. Okay, and this is how we color grade a ProRes file and make it look very nice and cinematic, very rich, in a few easy steps. So thank you guys for watching. Be sure to click like, be sure to subscribe, check out my professional series of origami LUTs for Blackmagic Camera, Red, Alexa, and DJI, and I'm gonna see ya in the next videos. Take care.